Respected Principal, Dr. Sri Kumar sir, Dr. Murali sir, Dr. Nagabhushanam sir, Dr. Anandalakshmi ma'am, Dr. Sunil sir, other faculties, PG and UG scholars. I, Dr. Sneha N. Titus.
I, Dr. Nutan Mahto from Kaya Chikitsa Department.
On behalf of our institute, Government Ayurveda Medical College, Tripunithara, welcome you all to the national webinar on Trigunas in Theory and Practice. Prayer is not asking. Prayer is putting oneself in the hands of the God. So let's begin this section with a prayer. For that, I would like to invite Dr. Vishnu Datta for the same.
Shankham Chakram Jalauka Dadadamrudakhadam Charudorphischadurphihi Sukshma Swachadi Hrityam Amshuka Parivilasam Maulimam Bhojanitram Kalabodujjalangam Kaditadavilasal Charudbidambarathyam Vandeya Dhanvantarimtham Nikhila Gadavana Praudadavagnililam.
The mind is fickle, it won't obey you. Every time the mind misbehaves, use your discretionary intellect to bring it back to the equanimous position. A very warm good evening and namaste to all. According to Indian philosophy, Trigunas, that is Sattva, Rajas and Tamas, are present in everyone. But it is the relative predominance of one of the Trigunas that determines personality of an individual. These Trigunas, in different proportions, influence the mental and intellectual caliber of every individual. Gunas mainly indicates the attitude with which human mind functions. Trigunas have a unique concept in Ayurveda and also have a key role in common clinical practice in relation to Tridosas.
This webinar highlights application of Trigunas in universe, in nature, Dinacharya, Ritucharya, pathogenesis and in treatment. As Ayurveda people, we are more focused on Tridoshas. Actually, Tridoshas are reflections of Trigunas. As body and mind are connected to each other, Trigunas have equal importance as that of Tridoshas. So, to begin with this webinar, we now request Dr. Sunil sir, Professor, Department of Kaya Chikitsa, to deliver the welcome address.
Respected Principal Dr. T.D. Srikumar sir, our former Kaya Chikitsa HODs Dr. K. Murali, Dr. K. K. Ramani, Dr. Shailama, very respected faculties, practitioners, PG and UG scholars from all over India and abroad. So happy that around 2000 valuable graduates for this webinar. As you know, Trigunas are equally important as Tridoshas. The relation between mind and body are very clearly explained and practically mentioned in Ayurveda and practiced in ancient Ayurveda. But unfortunately, the new generation needs to tackle the mind in common practice. This webinar is planned to enlighten the scholars in refreshing your current knowledge about Trigunas and empower you to make use of Trigunas in common practice. I think in the future, marriage proposals will check for matching Trigunas of couple. A good clinician have to observe and take decision on management only after knowing the Triguna predominance of the patient. It's so enthusiastic that the delegates started heavy discussions in the 8 webinar WhatsApp groups we prepared from last 2 days. Yesterday, Dr. Arya in the pre-webinar introduced the subject and the concept of Triguna. The webinar today, we hope to enlighten you to revive your current knowledge. I welcome our respected principal, who is the backbone of our program and is here with us for the inauguration. I welcome you, sir.
Thank you, Sunil.
I welcome the director of Kerala Ayurveda Medical Education, who is very busy in his heavy work schedule, who gave us this felicitation message will be delivered after this. I welcome the director. I welcome the presenters, the resource persons, and the felicitator, Dr. Vijayma, to the program. On behalf of the Kai Chikitsa Department, I welcome all the delegates and other dignitaries. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you very much, sir, for your warm welcome. Next, I would like to invite Dr. T.D. Srikumar, sir, Principal, Government Ayurveda College, Tripunitura. Sir has teaching experience of 24 years, starting from 1996 to till now. Sir was the professor of Rasashastra and Vaisajya Kalpana Department from 2008 and former Deputy Drugs Controller of Kerala. Remembering his valuable backbone support to this webinar, we invite Dr. T.D. Srikumar, sir, to inaugurate this section. Welcome you, sir.
Respected Murali, sir, Dr. Ananda Lakshmi, Dr. Nagabhushan, and their colleagues and participants all over the country, I welcome you all once again to this great event. It's with immense pleasure that I should congratulate my Kai Chikitsa Department team, especially heading with Dr. Sunil John, for arranging such a wonderful mega event. We were blessed with a Jesuit, I think among the Ayurveda colleges in the Kerala state. We got the first Jesuit, and on that, this event seems to be the mega event. I'm really proud of that. And as we know that the Trigunas of mind, according to Ayurveda, we have like Tridosha, Tristuna, Trayobastamba, Tisraishaniya, all these triads are interlinked with these Trigunas. So hopefully a bright discussion will be held after this, all this session. I wish all the very best for this session, and with all your consent, with all your permission and blessings, I officially declare and inaugurate this mega event. Thank you very much.
Thank you, sir, for inaugurating this section. Next, we have a message from Dr. Harikrishnan Thirumangalat, sir, Director, Ayurveda Medical Education of Kerala. And the message is, it's so happy to know that the Department of Kai Chikitsa, Government Ayurveda College, is conducting a national webinar on a seldom discussed but a very pertinent subject, Trigunas in Theory and Practice, on 22nd August 2020 and a pre-webinar on 21st August 2020. The pre-webinar was over yesterday with around 2,000 privileged delegates from all over the world registered and gathered, and in which around 400 were faculties of various academic institutions. The novel technological innovations have infinite chances in the global post-COVID phase. Knowledge sharing is one among them. In this pleasant evening, I congratulate Team Tripunitura for this great venture and appreciate the Department of Kai Chikitsa for organizing such a knowledge sharing event.
Thank you, sir, for gracing this event by conveying a beautiful message, and thank you for your support. Next, we would like to honor our special guest for this evening and others who have contributed to today's seminar. For that, we invite Dr. Vijay Nag, sir, Secretary, Adhyapak Sangathan, Government Ayurveda College, Tripunitura, for the felicitation speech. Please welcome.
Namaste. Namaste. Hope I am audible.
Yes, sir.
Hope I am audible.
Yes, sir, you are audible.
Okay. Respected Director of Ayurveda Medical Education, Dr. Harikrishnan Thirumangalat, sir. Respected Principal of Government Ayurveda College, Tripunitura, Dr. T.D. Srikumar, sir. Former HOD of Kai Chikitsa, Government Ayurveda College, Tripunitura, Dr. Murali, sir. respected principal of Shantagiri Ayurveda College, Dr. Nagabhushanam sir, professor and HOD of Kriya Sharira Department, Government Ayurveda College, Trivandrum, Dr. Anandalakshmi madam, associate professor and HOD in charge of Kaya Chikitsa Department, Government Ayurveda College, Tripunithara, Dr. Sunil John sir, assistant professor of Department of Kaya Chikitsa, Government Ayurveda College, Tripunithara, Dr. Asha Karunakaran madam, faculties and participants, a very good evening to you all. Government Ayurveda College Tripunithara is an institute which is nearing its centenary. The Kaya Chikitsa department is a shining gem as far as our academy is concerned. With an OPD turnout of more than 100 patients per day, this department renders its service to people throughout the Kerala. It has produced some great physicians like Dr. Sadanandan, Dr. K.K. Ramani and Dr. K. Murali, and is continuing its legacy. Today, the discourse organized by the Kaya Chikitsa department is on a very interesting and highly debated topic, Trigunas in Theory and Practice. We have three learned scholars who will enlighten us on this topic. On my personal behalf and on behalf of Adhyapaka Sangatana, that is Government Ayurveda College Teachers Association, I extend my best wishes and prayers to this endeavor. Thank you.
Thank you, sir, for your felicitation speech. Now, I would like to invite Dr. K. Murali, sir, former HOD, Department of Kaya Chikitsa. Sir has retired from his service as superintendent of Government Ayurveda College Hospital in the month of May 2020. Sir has 32 years of teaching experience and was honored with the Best Teacher Award by the state government. Currently, sir is the chief editor of Kottikkal Arya Vaidyashala Publications. Sir is a known orator and also writer of many Ayurvedic scientific papers. He is the son of great Vaidya and commentator of Ashtanga Sangraha Prakashika Vyakhyana, Padma Bhushan, Vaidya Bhushanam, Raghavan Tirumulpat sir. On behalf of all gathered here, we welcome you sir for delivering the keynote address.
Thank you, Dr. Sneha, for the nice introduction. Respected Principal Dr. T.D. Sri Kumar, Dr. Nagabhushanam, Principal Shantagiri Ayurveda College, and Dr. Anandalakshmi, Professor of Kriya Sharira Department, Government Ayurveda College, Thiruvananthapuram. Respected former Head of the Department of Kaya Chikitsa, Dr. K.K. Ramani, and Dr. Shailamma, Professor of Department of Kaya Chikitsa, Government Ayurveda College, Kannur. Dr. Sunil K. John, the present Head of the Department of Kaya Chikitsa, colleagues, and the participants from far and wide, a very good morning to all. It is a matter of pleasure to associate with Department of Kaya Chikitsa, Government Ayurveda College, Tripunithara, where I was the head of the department a few months back. The social situation has made us to convert the national seminar into a webinar, but it can be considered positive as participants from far and wide can communicate more efficiently through a single platform. At the outset, the topic of today's discussion is Trigunas, concept of Trigunas and its application. There are two resource persons. Dr. Anandalakshmi is to speak on the physiological perspective and Dr. Nagabhushanam its clinical application. The concept of Trigunas originally evolved in Sankhya system of Indian philosophy. One of the unique view of this system is Satkaryavada. Karya or effect pre-exist in Karna or cause, or rather the material cause. The same is accepted by Ayurveda also. Karanaanivithayitval karyanam tal sobhavata, as mentioned in Garbhavakrandiya chapter of Ashtanga Hridayam. The cosmogenesis theory of Sankhya is also accepted by Sushruta. The Pragati Purusha concept is also reflected here. Pragati, or precisely Moola Pragati, is the root cause of the whole worldly objects. To quote from Sushruta, Sarva Bhudanam Karanam Akaranam Sattva Rajas Tamo Rupam Ashtarupam Akhilasya Jagadaha Sambhava Hidura Abhyaktam Nama. So the Abhyakta or Moola Pragati is said to be of no cause, Akaran, but it is the cause of whole worldly objects. The nature of this Moola Pragati is obscure, hence the name Avyakta. Moola Pragati is termed as Sattva Rajas Tamo Mayam. How can this be? This Moola Pragati is Avyakta or obscure, then how can we be sure about its Trigunatva? So theory of Satkaryavada comes here. The Karana and Karya, or cause and effect, should be identical according to Satkaryavada. If we assess the expressions of the world, its functions, color, etc., they can be classified into three: light, movement, inertia are representative of some principles. So these principles are identified as sattva, rajas and tamas. Generally, these three are termed as gunas. But here, guna is not similar to the concept of gunas in Nyaya Vaisheshika. In Nyaya Vaisheshika schools, gunas are properties attached to dravya. But in Sankhya school, guna means something that is of secondary significance or less significance. When compared to Moola Pragati, Gaunatvat, gunas are of less significant. So the guna in Sankhya is different from that of Nyaya Vaisheshika schools. We know that Sattva is Lakhu, Prakashaka, Rajas is Chala and motivating, Tamas is Guru and enveloping. Here certain properties are attached to Trigunas. According to the Nyaya Vaisheshika school, Gunas cannot have Gunas. This is accepted in Ayurveda also. Adha Dravya Sridha Prakta Nirguna Nishkriya Guna. If gunas are accepted having gunas, there will be uncertainty in relation between gunas. So it is not proper to consider sattva, rajas and tamas gunas. They are actually constituents of Moola Pragati. If we accept this fact, there is no problem in attributing gunas like Lakhu, Upastambhaka, etc. to these sattva, rajas and tamas. So similarly, Charaka has also considered Trigunas are the components of mind, Tribhagam Manaha. The concept of Trigunas influenced Ayurveda in several ways, perhaps even in the evolution of Dosha theory. Sattva, rajas, tamas are mutually contradictory. Sattva is Lakhu while Tamas is Guru. Then how they coexist in the universe? This is evidenced by the example of lamp, Pradibhavat Pravrittihi. In a lamp, there are the wick or varti, flame or the agni, oil or taila. They coexist, maintaining the flame glowing. So same is the situation in the body also, in terms of doshas. Vata is Shida, but Pitta is Ushna. Kapha is Guru, but Vata is Lakhu. Though there are contradictions between these gunas, they coexist to maintain the body. So this is well explained in Ashtanga Sangraha, आरंभकं विरोधेभि मिथो यद्वत् गुणत्रयम् विश्वस्य दृष्टं युगपत् व्याधेर् दोषत्रयम् तथा. सो दिस इज ए रिलेशन बिटवीन त्रिगुणास, कॉन्सेप्ट ऑफ त्रिगुणास एंड त्रिदोषास. इट कैन बी अस्यूम्ड दैट द आइडिया ऑफ त्रिदोषास केम इनटू द माइंड ऑफ आचार्यस फ्रॉम द थियरी ऑफ त्रिगुणास. सो देर आर चांसेस ऑफ दोषा थियरी influenced by the concept of trigunas as manifestations of whole world can be interpreted in terms of sattva rajas tamas. All the bodily functions can also be expressed through these three doshas. Trigunas are termed in Ayurveda as mahagunas. They are considered as components of mind, like vata pitta kapha are the components of body. The functioning of mind can be well explained with trigunas. Similarly, the morbid changes of the mind can also be studied in the light of trigunas. Now in this evening we are to attend two sessions on trigunas in two different perspectives. I invite the attention of all the participants to the lectures and request you to actively participate in the discussions to be followed. Thank you. Thank you for the listening. Thank you all.
As we have moved on to the last part of our section, we would like to call upon Dr. Asha Ma'am, Assistant Professor, Department of Kaya Chikitsa, to deliver the vote of thanks.
Honorable Chief Guest, invited resource persons, teachers, delegates, and my dear students. A warm good evening to all. I am honored and lucky to have the opportunity to express my gratitude on this special day. It is very precious that we have hosted the national webinar on Trigunas in Theory and Practice in the Department of Kaya Chikitsa, Government Ayurveda College, Tripunithara. Certainly, these 2 days were very useful and we all got opportunity to make aware ourselves with the trigunas. On behalf of the Kaya Chikitsa department, I express my heartfelt thanks to our principal, Dr. T.D. Srimar sir, for his constant support and courageous inaugural speech.
It is Thank a pleasure you, that
it is a pleasure okay it is a pleasure that Director of Ayurvedic Medical Education, Dr. Harikrishnan Thirumangalan sir, has enlightened us with a fruitful message to this occasion. I thank you, sir, on the behalf of Kaya Chikitsa department. Let me thank Dr. Vijaynath V, Secretary Adhyapaka Sanghadana Tripunithara, for your valuable felicitations in our program. I am also very grateful to our former HOD, Government Ayurveda College, Tripunithara, Dr. Murali sir, now working as Chief Editor, Publications Department, Kottakkal. Ayurveda Shala is a good planner, motivator, and a wonderful personality in the field of Ayurveda who has delivered a keynote for a creative beginning. I also thank Dr. Ramani teacher and former HOD, Department of Kaya Chikitsa, and Dr. Shailamma teacher in this occasion on behalf of Department of Kaya Chikitsa, Tripunithara. I may like to express our sincere thanks to our chief guest, Dr. Ananthalakshmi K.N., Professor and HOD, and Dr. G. Nagabhushan, Sir, Principal Chandigiri Ayurveda College, for the speech which explains how to explore Trigunas and its reflections in body and mind, as well as clinical practice. They taught us Trigunas in an interesting, brainstorming, mindful, and thought-provoking way. Now I thank Dr. Janish, Assistant Professor, Department of Basic Principle, for making us a platform for a national webinar with the technical support. I also extend my thanks to Dr. Sunil John, the present HOD, Kaya Chikitsa, for constructing this idea in a creative way. And I thank Dr. Arya, our final year PG students, who has enlightened with us an introduction to practical aspects of Trigona in pre-webinar, which is a memorable one. About 2,000 delegates has participated in the webinar for making it a great success. I thank every one of our delegates on behalf of Kai Chikitsa Department. I would like to thank the organizing team of teachers and Dr. Anu and Dr. Sangeeta MO and students behind this webinar for the valuable inputs. This webinar wouldn't be possible without our PG students, PG diploma students, house surgeon. The constant work and support made this occasion a great success. At last, but not at the fourth year student who designed our poster and certificates for our program. Once again, I thank each and everyone who participated in the webinar to make this event successful. Thank you.
Thank you everyone for being with us in this beautiful evening and also for your patience. And thanks for making this a successful event. Thank you all.
Thank you all.